There we go. All the enablers, all those who are powering this conclave. Huge round of gratitude from the organizers, the hosts. But now it's time for someone who's really the fountainhead of all this. He's a serial entrepreneur, he's a media mogul, he's a journalist, but more than all, he's an eternal optimist, all rolled into one, the founder of Exchange for Media Group. May we have him on stage right now, Annurag Batra, as he delivers the welcome address.
Good afternoon. It's my honor and privilege to be here. It's a dream come true. Sneha Walke, who's our head of South in Exchange for Media, joined 7 years back, and I've been telling Sneha that we should do more things in South. And Sneha and her team have been able to put this together. So first of all, you know, it's customary to thank your colleagues at the end, but AAP is a people business. And I can say that we have, in this business, the best people working with us. So I'd like to congratulate Sneha, Priyanka, Akshita, Jyotsna, for putting this together. Since the time we started Exchange for Media, we've been a national player. We've had an office in Calcutta for 10 years, one person though, but we came to South and we put an office 12 years back here. One of my colleagues who used to precede Sneha as the head of South is an entrepreneur now. Ajay did great work for us, run Circuit Night. So first of all, Sneha, this is the start. I hope you do more in South, not just in Bangalore. I'd like to, you know, it's ironical, Malayala Manorama has given us a printed diary, no iPads, but next time, Sneha, you should ask them for iPads, but right now I took my notes on it. But I'd like to welcome some special people, all of you are special, who come all the way and you come to listen to them. Mr. Hemant Malik, he really doesn't need an introduction. He's leading the ITC fastest growing business, which is the FMCG business. And I've consumed their products. I can tell you your coffee is fantastic. Sanjeev gave me a hamper, and after that I started to buy it. Also, I got from Anil Rajput a big hamper, so I've consumed it. Fantastic coffee. I can say that I'm trying not to eat biscuits, but I'm sure my kids like them. Mr. CVL Srinivas, I can tell you that 4 years back, our first big event, I would say one of the most successful events of Exchange for Media, because we had Mr. Mark Patterson. Srini was kind enough to allow us an opportunity to host him, and we put our heart into it, and we had a lovely evening. I'd like to thank Srini for being here. Srini is somebody who doesn't really need an introduction in the media industry. I happened to meet Mr. Kariappa for the first time, but thank you, Mr. Kariappa, for being here. You have relevance in my life in more ways than one. For those of you wondering what, he is the president of the brand called Jockey. Somebody I met very recently, and you know, I took instant liking to him. I'm not sure he did. In fact, when he entered the room, I said, the one person you should definitely meet is Srini, and the one person you should stay away from is me. But I'd like to welcome Mr. Amit Gupta, who's the president and CEO of the Asianet News Network. He worked with Mr. Rajiv Chandrasekhar on the investment side in media, and now he's having to execute what he proposed and became part of. Thank you, Amit, for being here. Mr. Pradeep Dwivedi. Pradeep is a friend and is part of almost all our initiatives. And I can say that, you know, Raj is possibly the most likable person in our business, right? I say that at least. My father-in-law and my wife tell me that if you want to do something in life, be like Raj Nayak. I've heard that like multiple times. But I can say somebody who can really give him competition is Pradeep. And I say that I know everybody in this business, very likable person. My friend, I had the good pleasure of working with Mohit. Mohit Joshi is here from Havas. You know, in fact, I remember, I think I'm part of his being called Mojo, because I saw this Mike Myers movie. I won't go into details. You know, all of you are wealthy, so you must be trying to buy houses or invest in real estate. We have Amit Wadhwani, who's a young entrepreneur from Sai Estates. He's here. We had a real estate conclave last night here, and Amit was part of it. Thank you, Amit, for being part. I've met lots of old friends from the media whom, when we started Exchange for Media, me and Naval used to meet them. DVD, I can tell you our first relationship with Deccan started with you. I have my friend who has multiple roles, who's the president of the Ad Club. I'm not an expert on media or on the Indian media in South, but I know a little bit about media. The more you know, the less you know. But I can outline five trends that are happening that I've gathered from being here multiple times and on this trip. One is that the dominant player, which was Sun, is no longer the most dominant player. Still very dominant. It is 60% player in the market, but it's not the most dominant. While the market has grown, it hasn't grown. It's pretty much, it's still very dominant. I mean, but in future, there are other players that are that may take money from Sun. So that's one big trend. Second, and you know, Deccan Herald and the sponsor, my content is not influenced by sponsors. Pradeep is here from a leading newspaper. Print will continue to be fairly large. I know Srini is betting a lot of money on digital, in TV, and all of that will grow on the back of new brands. For example, if you look at Bangalore, the major categories that represent Bangalore in advertising are tech, BFSI, e-commerce, and FMCG. These are broadly. And the fifth category, real estate. Now, in commerce, we've added Amazon, Flipkart, Jabong. If you looked at the advertising over the last one quarter, you know, Amazon, Flipkart, I mean, these are Bangalore headquarters, so I'm talking about them. And, you know, the real estate industry in Bangalore is possibly the least impacted relatively. I'm talking relatives. And this is because the real estate developers built brands. So they've stayed in the consumer's mind. I may also say that in Bangalore and in the southern market, the biggest market is Karnataka, and within that is Bangalore, because it's a very large urban population. So print will continue to do well. In fact, I keep saying that the print players have to, you know, put a better face, because we are doing really well. Why should we be on the back foot? We should talk about our own stories. The three other trends that I noticed is that most media brands that are national are approaching the southern market in a big way. Look at what Colors has done, right? The second is print is building a solution-oriented culture, and print is no longer print. Legacy brands and print are building TV and video platforms, not necessarily TV platform, which the advertisers and consumers are using. Third, it's happening in every part of India, so it's southern market is more and more clients are looking at solutions, experiential, a bundled offering. They're not just looking at pure print or pure television. You know, they're looking at a solution oriented. Digital. Digital is the fastest growing. I won't deny that, because the base is small. And, you know, the beauty in southern India is, I know in digital, Facebook and Google and Facebook in that order are pretty much 85% of the marketplace. But in the southern India, the digital players are growing very fast. And I say the next Exchange for Media Conclave, apart from the brands that are partnered, will be sponsored by an Amazon Flipkart, because they have a huge advertising-led model now. You know, they want to recover all the money they spent on media, right? And last but not the least, which is the most important thing, and I alluded to it by saying that the real estate has stayed a large advertiser, because real estate brands got created many years. So the new Indian brands, which are local, regional, will, in this competitive landscape, increase their spends. They may not be huge spends in terms of absolute volumes, but when all these brands spend more than they used to, it will become a large value proposition for media owners. These are broadly the trends. The Indian news ecosystem in the South is expanding. Asianet is, of course, taking the lead there. Almost every player is making a unique offering in the news television space, because also we are talking about news products almost 10 months before elections. So all the news products in southern India are geared up to make sure they do unique programming and are able to take unique offering. So southern media marketplace is poised to grow bigger as the impact of GST and demonetization become lesser and lesser, and the compliances from large brands become better. I think the growth in consumers' appetite for going back to some of these products and services, and hence brands like ITC spending more in these local markets, will accentuate, and that will mean a growth for the Indian media, the Indian language media based in South, and especially in Karnataka and Bangalore. I hope we are at the forefront of creating solutions that help this ecosystem grow. I'm going to talk briefly about what are our new initiatives. In Exchange for Media, the three initiatives that I will talk about, which are immediate, one is our Indian Marketing Awards. Mr. Anand Kripalu, who's based in this city, was the chairperson of our Indian Marketing Awards jury and had jury members who are equally prominent and know about brands and have built businesses on the back of brands. So that's on 7th December at the Leela Gurgaon. We have the India Brand Conclave in the day, and we have the Indian Marketing Awards in the evening. This is the 13th year of the Impact Person of the Year. On 11th December at ITC Parel, we have our Impact Person of the Year. Srini has been a nominee in the past, and I'm sure he'll be a winner with the kind of work he's doing for Group M in this marketplace. We have the Impact Person of the Year on the 11th December. It's a Monday, and I promise you that the Impact Person of the Year this year will be bigger than it ever has been in terms of the kind of brand owners present, the kind of scale we will do it at. It's a television quality event this year. Last but not the least, the Exchange for Media News Broadcast Awards are very dear to me personally. I think the news ecosystem is very important. I've said that there is a fight for the soul of this country happening in the past, and people like Srini are in the room, people like Mojo, brand owners like Mr. Kariappa. I think we have to make sure that the Indian news broadcasting ecosystem becomes more mature, is able to do more in-depth reporting, and is not necessarily as sensational as it is. I know we all like spicy food. So there is a fight for the soul of this country happening. The news broadcasting ecosystem is at the forefront of making sure that the Indian public at large makes opinions on issues, on initiatives that the government takes. So we have our Indian News Broadcast Awards, which is the 9th edition this year, on 10th February at the Radisson Noida. We do it there because it's next to the news ecosystem. And the 1st February is the jury. Srini's been part of the jury. In fact, I remember either he was the chair or he was part of the jury which gave Arnab Goswami his first award 7 years back. We did pick up winners early on. This was 7 years back. So I just want to say these are some of the Exchange for Media initiatives that I want to talk about. I spend all my time in business world. When Mr. Kariappa came to me, I said, I'm not running the event, but I'll put in a word. I did that. We stay on time. But I want to tell you, I talked about print owners don't do a good job at telling their own stories. But in business world, when we acquired it 4 years back, it was just a print product. We still have a long way to go. Maybe another 6 to 8 months, we'll be where we want. But we've grown the print product. We built a site which does between 15 to 20 million traffic every month and growing fast. We built a communities business because clients look at solutions. And we built a very large experiential and solutions space. Our latest issue has record advertising. It's a 280-page issue. We're doing a 200-page issue almost every issue with about 40 to 60 pages of ads. So I do want to talk about the business world. And I think we do very little in business world in the southern marketplace except what we do for the tech company. Over the next 6 months, we will increase our engagement with everyone that has to deal with business world. Wanted to welcome you to the first edition of the Exchange for Media Conclave South. We plan to take away, we are not mind readers, Rini, but we are going to take it to Calcutta and Chennai and other cities. We believe that the action is in the states and in the next level cities, as we call them. In fact, our vision, mine and Naval's vision, is to take the Exchange for Media Conclave to at least top 40 cities in the country, talk about local brands, because the growth for media and growth for the business ecosystem will come from these local brands. Thank you for being here, and I look forward to learning something about media advertising communication today. God bless you.
I guess it is we who learn from you, and it was one welcome address that felt like the keynote, but that's also for the insights shared. And really, very heartwarming to hear the note on the print media in particular. Thank you so much, Mr. Annurag Batra.